Some of the background that Noreen didn't mention was, it was mentioned that we've got progressive taxation system in place. Now, the government ignored this in the recent campaign of introducing charges. But charges were first abolished in 1977. Then in 1995, 96, they tried to reintroduce charges and there was protests. And after a lot of debate, a new system was devised, a new system of taxation was devised, and there was an act brought in place that's called the 1997 Act for the funding of, to support local councils for the funding of water services and sanitation services. That act is still in place. The amount collected comes to around 1.2 billion per annum, and it's been taken in every year since 1997. The government never mentioned this in any of their propaganda, but the act is in place, we're still paying it. What happened was that the government took in the money and did not use it as they said they would use it. So by the time of 2014, only 300 million of the 1.2, approximate 1.2 billion, it was being spent on water services. what really started to motivate people to get involved in the campaign was, we had a minister for the environment who was asked the question, what will happen if people don't pay? And he said, his response was, we'll turn the water down to a trickle. And the people said, no, we won't accept that. He got promoted, he's commissioner of farming in Brussels at the moment. But his government faced the biggest opposition that they ever did because of that single statement. So sometimes politicians are stupid enough to shoot themselves in the foot. Because they give us a reason to get off our backsides, to get on the street, stop meters. I don't have a meter, and some of my neighbors don't have meters. Unfortunately, a lot of people do have meters now. And as Roy said, there is now a campaign to remove those meters. What really, I've been involved in the TTIP Free Zones campaign. My county was one of the first TTIP Free Zones in Ireland. Found out about it in Germany, in Berlin in 2014, and I'm back home, and 5 months later, we were TTIP Free Zone. But the reason I got involved in it was because of the privatization issue. CETA, TTIP, TISA, they're all about privatization. And I saw that I was involved in the anti-fracking movement because of the damage it would do to water. And I felt that if these trade agreements were brought in, the fracking would happen and the water would be privatized. And we've seen it up there in Article 9 of CETA. There's actually a paragraph later on which says that if the water service had been kind of contracted out already, then really it could be and will be privatized. So the fight goes on, you know, even though we've won a battle, we haven't won the war. That's all that's happened in Ireland. And my condolences to the Greek people. I was following I was looking for a photograph there of the time of Oxy. And I had a flag of Greece painted on my face and a poster in solidarity, but unfortunately the Troika won out. We may try and make sure that they don't, you know, get our water into that. So, you know, I'll be joining Rory Murphy and a lot more, like 100,000 plus in the streets of Dublin. The population of around 5 million is not a bad turnout when you consider the population of Germany produced 250 million in the streets of Berlin 3 years ago. So it gives an indication of the strength of our opposition to privatization of our water and water services. Thank you.